I'll have to declare as a journalist a conflict of interest over here. I've known Raghu since I was, I think, 17 years old. I walked into his office and he's working at the Statesman at that time, and went up to him and said, I want to become a photographer. And he just bagaoed me. He said, ja ke khicho. I said, can I follow you around? He said, nahi, tum apna ap ja ke khicho. So that was the end of my career as a photographer. Then we've had subsequent trips together to Sikkim on an assignment, and then also to Kargil, where it's a long story, but I want to leave the time for Raghu and Avni and Anurag to talk about the film. Now, you start with, and I think Anurag, I'll throw this sentence that Raghu says in the film to you also, to both of you. He says to his daughter Avni, you need a cool eye and a warm heart. You have to have silence inside you. Now, I know that's his, but Anurag, I think there's a lot of noise after you see your films of Gangs of Wasseypur and all. It's a noisy inside. So we'll come to that. Raghu, tell me, how do you address your silence and the kind of art he creates and the kind of art you create?
You see, in his case, it's all scripted, structured, everything. And in my case, if I have to get into a situation where I have to organize anything, I cannot capture and create anything magical. But having said that, because I am a candid photographer, I'm a street photographer. But having said that, I'll say even in his case, no matter what he's structured and scripted, the ability to go beyond the structures and find something which is just emerging out of maybe their bad acting or bad movement, I am throwing a challenge.
No, I think my approach is pretty much like him, because I have a movie camera and not a still camera, and the streets are chaotic. So when I roll my camera, I capture the chaos that's there, and he's seen me shoot.
So when you're dealing with actors, for example, and you're not getting the shot that you want,
and that never happens,
then you go crazy.
I give different feedbacks to different actors. I create chaos. I create chaos, and they don't know where the camera is. I always shoot like...
But for me, the whole world looks so chaotic. So the meaning of silence is that you are not, you haven't pre-planned, you are not programmed to do certain kind of, or to take certain kind of photograph. Because actually a little while ago, you know, Hindustan Times correspondent was asking me that what is the best approach? The ability to merge, to connect, and mentally, physically, and spiritually, and let the situations speak to you, which means you have the silence to listen to the whispers. And that's where the most creative aspect lies in photography, my kind.
Avni, a daughter making a documentary on her father, that's a very risky venture. Because a father wants to be seen, in a certain way by his child.
Everybody, sorry.
Yes, everyone. I'm talking about everyone, not you.
I blame only
me. I'm not blaming you, but fathers and mothers, as a matter of fact, like to be seen in a certain way. And it really matches how the children actually see us.
Yeah.
Did you feel the pressure of his expectations of that while you were filming him?
Okay,
and
so
especially since he's in the same similar field of choosing frames.
So when I started, I felt no pressure because he didn't really think much of me.
No, I thought she was just joking,
yeah,
having fun.
So, okay, so I was in Bombay and...
I will disturb her, and this is not trying to block her, this is... I had finished 2012 Gangs of Wasseypur, and there was this bunch of kids there. And the child who was most chaotic and most screaming was this 19-year-old brat, which was Avani Rai. And then I was like, who are you? And then I found out, and she would not say, she would never take her father's name, so things like that. But she was always shouting, yelling. Then she one day invited me to the photography exhibition he was holding, and we had a chat. And he was also like, how do we deal with this one? So I did not, it was started as an exercise. It was not meant to be a documentary. Yeah. It was not meant to be anything.
Precisely.
I said, your problem is you don't know your father. So take the camera and follow him and find out who he is. Go to where he started from. That's how it started. Over the years, it became what it became. And then she would keep coming back to me and I said, I'm not your producer. I just started it. Find a producer. Do it. No, now you
what
have an
did
idea.
What did you go to him for?
So I...
To Anurag for.
So when you're 18, 19, I sent him a message saying, ye mere paas footage collect ho rahi hai jo main ghar ja ke shoot kar rahi hu, main kya karun iska? So he said, agar tu honestly karegi, to main tere ko support karunga. Okay, now that meant all the things that it could mean without babysitting me, basically. So when that idea actually became real because of him. So that's why he is the reason it's all started. And then it became more and more serious. So the first time he took it a bit seriously was when he said, oh, Anurag is saying, okay. Oh, Ika is saying, okay. Now I better behave myself and now give her some space, you know. And not also give her space many times.
So did your level of respect change for Avni as you...
No, it took much longer than that. Actually, to begin with.
Ye bachi hai, usko bhi bhaga raha tha.
Ah. Oh, I gave her the toughest time. I made her cry. I'll book an air ticket for her to come with me and cancel it. Because I thought her pace and my pace were different. She cried and she'll ring up her mom. She's sitting somewhere here. And she will try to negotiate between us.
That you see in the film, that Mita's presence in the film between the two of you seems like a referee.
Yeah.
There's a calming presence behind.
Yes.
Which is how Mita is. And I think what you're describing is pretty mean.
Anyway.
What you did to
absolutely.
Her. How could you do that?
No, you see, first of all.
He did that and I was the punching bag. My only role in this documentary was when she could not yell at him, she came and yelled at me.
And did you respond like a father or as a friend?
I've also been hard to her. I've been pretty hard.
He was very hard too, but you would hear me. And also he is a producer even though he says he isn't, but he gave me whatever I needed when I started. And he let me be, basically. And that was big, you know, that someone is letting you be. And the fact is, you're going to Bombay for the first time and there's someone like Anurag, who you've always respected, saying, "Dekho, jo karna hai kar, main support karunga, lekin mere ko tang mat karna." So, that was,
you don't want something. But during the filming of it, he's seen on film giving you directions. And then you tell him, in rather a sweet voice, but you do tell him, "Hey, it's my film. Stop giving me directions."
He saw the film at the premiere. We couldn't let him in the edit room.
Because he would have started saying, ye kato, ye dalo.
He said, I'll tell you what
he's
he said.
He's a control freak, that I know.
He said, puri film black and white kar do pehle to.
No, you see the ability to...
Phir usme, can I use his favorite words? Phir usme dam aayega. Usme energy aayegi.
No, the ability to start all over again, I tell you. The whole cosmos will come and support you. And in any case, why we had so many fights? Initially, when she started filming with the ordinary camera, I thought, "Theek hai, bachchi ye ghar mein khel rahi hai, khelne do." And then, when these guys and their name, and she brought other people to talk to me because I will not repeat, I will not talk to her serious things. Ke kya piche pad gayi? Why? Because first of all, I am not fond of the fact that your daughter or your son is writing a book on you or doing a film on you. It's self-indulgent. Too much. And I thought, kya ye idea leke aaye yaar ki mere pe aake ye film banati hai. And I didn't understand. But what was so good, she was consistent. She, if I tell her, "Baby, this is where you are sitting and take shooting," is a wrong angle. She said, "Papa, this is my film."
But in one section, you were right. When she was taking it from one side and you said ghumao, it was, I think, in a mosque.
The possibility to aur bhi hai.
You changed the frame, you listened to him. And it did make all the difference because you got the light from the back from the archway, from the door. And he was right, I'm sorry to say.
Yeah, he was. And yeah. That was 2012. And he was right. I mean, I don't have much to say because he was right.
Will you give her the freedom to make mistakes?
On me?
Yes.
God forgive, yes.
Anurag, do you think a new filmmaker should have the freedom? Now, you made your mistakes.
Yeah, absolutely.
You
know, she has made her mistakes. The first 3 years, she has made a lot of mistakes.
Yeah.
And all that you see there, she started to find and see, it started to come together after the third year.
Yeah, for sure.
So, and my whole thing also was, don't come and ask me if it's right or wrong. Find it yourself.
And also, he would do one more thing. Now, when the film is ready and I was closer to the end, he'd say, "Dekh, tu kaam ho gayi hai." I'm like, "Film ke baare mein kuch bolo." "Dekh, tu badal gayi hai." I'm like, "But film ke baare mein batao."
So maybe tu badli hai,
to
film badli.
See,
this is what he's saying.
You shot it, that as you were shooting it, you learned and you grew.
Yeah.
No, but you know, when she was, her film was picked up by ICA and other people who were funding it, then she rang me up from Amsterdam telling me, "Papa, can you imagine this is happening, that is happening? I hope you will have some respect for me."
You're harsh.
But, you know, this is the way I will treat any of my student who comes to me. Ye koi baat hi nahi. You can inherit your father's properties, but creativity cannot be inherited. Each step has to be taken personally, individually, and there is no other choice available to anybody. The only thing is, you know, that some people say, "Arey, Kumar Gandharv, dekhiye, wo itne saal ki umar mein gaane lag gaye, flana ye karne lag gaya." Kumar ji ke aaspaas agar har waqt sangeet bajta tha, to unke kaanon mein to sur pahunch rahe the. Aur agar wo 10 saal ya 12 saal ke baad agar gaana shuru karte hain, to charo taraf jab sangeet hai, jo instinctive training hoti hai, is the best training. So then, you can't say he was a genius. He became a genius. She can become a genius. This guy creating violence and being called a genius. Yeah. Kya kar sakte hain?
Anurag,
you know,
Anurag, what as now Avni has just started, and as you said, she's changed and she grew. Tell us about your journey a little bit. You know, your Black Friday, as you know, I didn't like the film. Yes, and then was completely
Black Friday. I remember you said ye documentary hai ki drama hai, kyunki dono to nahi ho sakta.
No, what I said was that everything that you showed was basically from news track. I wanted you to take it beyond that, and I was disappointed that you didn't take it beyond that. But I was wrong in the fact that all your subsequent films were genius, pure genius. Tell me, going from your film Black Friday, which I still stand was a bad film, stand by the fact that I think is a bad film, and got its publicity because it was banned, the rest of your films are pure genius. Now, can you talk a little bit about your journey as compared to what Avni is now just starting? You're already on your...
I think my journey is pretty similar, because when you see this film today, it's entirely Avni's. And in her process of finding out, everything that you see is her. There's not a single him or me in that film. He's the subject, and I was just the guy who switched on the button. I did nothing else. And in the journey, she has found herself, or is still in the process of it, with all the food. I refused to see her footage. She would always come for help. "Can you see it? Can you tell me what to do?" I said, "I won't. Find it yourself." It took longer. And knowing the person I knew then, and this one, that was a child I was dealing with. This one is somebody I can bounce things off.
That's a huge compliment, Avni.
Yeah, man.
You have that? Did you have a mentor?
I'm still on my journey. I had a mentor. Ramgopal Varma was my mentor. I made my mistakes. I fought with him. I did a lot of...
Ramgopal ki konsi film si maaf kijiye mujhe yaad.
Satya.
I think Satya was a watershed film because it broke the Bollywood formula.
It became my film school. It was literally my film school, because I spent 3 years on that film. I was a child. Yeah. I was a child. I was 21, 22 years old when I started on that film. And it was literally my film school. I've learned everything on that one film. And my journey is like, I have a lot of silence inside me because I put all the chaos on screen.
Good one.
And that's what had it happen.
So he has everything I'm dealing around, so he has a lot of noise around him. Noise to put the silence in his pictures? No.
I use my cinema to exorcise myself. Whenever I'm dealing with anything, I put it on screen.
That I know.
Everything. So my personal life. Okay. You want to know about my personal life? Watch my films. You'll get hints there. You want to know about how I'm dealing with politics? You watch my film. Everything I feel inside, I put it on screen. And after that, I go diving.
Where the real calm.
Honest reflection is where the magic lies. Yeah. You know? The rest is copy.
And that's why I'm very peaceful within.
Avni, what do you have to do about these two old blokes talking about you silence within?
They're talking to me on the same level, which is nice, you know. He would always be like, baby, kya kar rahi ho? Ab ye kaun sa lens hai? Ab tumne yahan se kuch naya seekh liya, toh mere pe dal rahi ho. And he would just say, go figure your shit out, man.
But there was a time, there's a part in the film where he's giving you some gyan about agar kaam karna hai to New Year's Eve ko bhul jao and this and that. No? And you're still a kid who wants to go and party also, no? It's normal. But he's giving you all this gyan. And then you say, don't talk shit, pa.
And my mother laughs piche. But,
so,
yeah.
So you still, she still has that rebellious streak to be able to tell you that. And you accept it.
क्या करें मानना पड़ता है नहीं एक बात तो है क्रिएटिव लाइसेंस जो है क्रिएटिविटी में जो जर्नी है जो पैशन है उसको अगर आप ब्लॉक करने या डायरेक्ट करने की कोशिश करेंगे द फ्लावर्स वोंट ब्लूम इट्स ओन काइंड अ फ्लावर ऑफ हर kind and her fragrance. So there can be thousands of flowers blooming in different spaces with that kind of creativity and energy. And that is the purpose of creativity. And that's why creative people are respected because unki khushbu alag hai. Kya baat hai yaar?
Nahi ji. Anurag is shooting the flowers. Aur uski bhi khushbu kaafi zabardast hai.
I shoot the cactus.
You shoot the cactus. You, Avni, also included his tantrum. When he's holding forth, giving his gyan, and then suddenly he stops and he says, you're looking this way and that way and you're ruining my concentration, and he throws the mic off. Hmm. Now, I've known that side of Raghu many times, and I did ask him once, kid, Raghu, tu itna genius hai, tu itna prima donna kyun karta hai? He said, ek ke saath dusra bhi aata hai.
Nahin, ye bhi nahin hai, dekho, aisa hai.
Par mujhe kaha tha.
Nahin, kaha to zarur tha, kyunki tab hum colleagues the, to maine socha ki thoda sa bhaav le lun. लेकिन ये बात जो है ना जब वो क्रिएटिव प्रोसेस जो है वो ऐसा है कि उसमें जब जर्नी में कोई रुकावट आती है तो तुम्हारा सारा सिस्टम जो है उखड़ने लगता है दैट्स वे यू नो थिंग्स बिकम डिफिकल्ट नॉट दैट यू आर अ प्रीमा डोना एंड यू थिंक यू आर द अल्टीमेट बिकॉज नथिंग इज अल्टीमेट इन दिस वर्ल्ड But the fact is that when you are on that trip, the intensity and power of it, if somebody is trying to block or redirect it, it's not possible.
Anurag, how do you deal with prima donnas?
I need to get my work done.
Gali guli.
Gali. मैं बहुत gently, बहुत प्यार से करता
हूँ. Gently माँ बहन की गाली करते हो?
ना माँ. मैं गाली देता
ना। Which brings us to sacred.
My set is actually the calmest set you will see in the whole film industry.
Now this brings us to sacred games. Huh. When I told my daughters, I said, you know, I have to see it all over again because I'm going to sit and write down all the galis and to remember them because it's really improved my vocabulary, gali vocabulary.
Gali.
They said you don't need it. Please don't do that. But I am going to do it. Now tell me about this film. I mean, it is totally taken. The viewers by storm. I think it's a watershed in Indian filmmaking in terms of concept, language, dialogue, the way women are shown, everything. And three episodes were written by a woman and the whole thing is edited by a woman, Aarti Bajaj, which goes to show that this whole stereotype of women only doing this gentle, lovely stuff shows that they've broken all those stereotypes. Tell us about Sacred Games. I know our audience is hugely interested in the making of it, what happened. And Avni, were you involved in it at all? No.
Okay. I love it.
Absolutely, yeah. So please tell us. Tell to us.
I actually.
The whole, everything about Sacred. 2 minutes.
Of course.
I actually came in very late on Sacred Games. And the person who's arrived today and is going to perform tonight is Varun Grover.
Yes.
He's been at the hem of it. He's the one who led the writer's room, Vikram Otwani. I came in much later and I was given the freedom to interpret the material they gave me. So Sacred Games actually began with them. So rightfully, it is Smita Singh, Varun Grover, Vasanth Nath, and Vikram Motwani. There's also another woman who bound it together, Aarti Bajaj and Alokananda. Alokananda is Buddhadev Das Gupta's daughter. She's done this amazing background score of the thing. But my job was to, I came in 10 or 12 days before the shoot started. And then I started to interpret it. Yes, the idea was to go in there and be truthful to it, because since it was Netflix. And that's the only way to approach it, is let's find as much truth within it as we can and not hold back. And galiyon ka wahi hota hai. Like once I met Oliver Stone in a flight and I told him, you put the F word on screen in Scarface. He said, no, that was all Pacino. I wrote one F, he made it into 10. So that's exactly what happens with galis. If you read the script of Vasipur, you will not see as many galis as the actors, when they start feeling free to improvise and they respond to situation, that's the best way to express.
No, listen, if you're living in India, especially in an Indian newsroom, it's a comma and full stop.
Yeah. It is. I'm saying it's the best way to express any kind of a thing.
Even serious, the MCPC just is automatic.
I genuinely believe it's actually more honest expression of frustration, of love, of anger than anything else. And it doesn't mean those things. The thing is, the day we can start talking about sex openly in this country, hume galiyon se bhi problem khatam ho jayegi.
Well, you know, Milan Kundera said that obscenity, what is called obscenity, the language, is the root connection of a man to his motherland. And I know that NRIs who live in America, when they meet Indians, and then they start the galis and MCBC, and then they say, kitne din ke baad zabaan khuli hai.
Absolutely.
Dil khush ho gaya. So, I mean, I think men are more attuned to that. There is a gender difference in that. Raghu, boliye. Aap kuch bolne wale the?
Nahi, rehne deta.
Kyun rehne de? Boliye, boliye. Hum kaise rok sakte hain? Boliye na.
Nahi, dekhi, gali jo hai, ye baat sahi hai. Kisi ne mujhe ek chota sa clip bheja tha. Ki wo Punjabi munda hai, baat baat pe gali deke baat karta hai. ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਉਹ ਜੋ ਖਾਣਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਬਣਿਆ ਚੰਗਾ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦੈਨ ਹਿਸ ਵਾਈਫ ਇਜ਼ ਕਮ ਸ਼ੀ ਇਜ਼ ਗੋਟ ਰੈਡੀ ਟੂ ਗੋ ਫੋਰ ਅ ਪਾਰਟੀ ਸ਼ੀ ਇਜ਼ ਓਪਨ ਬੜੀ ਸੋਹਣੀ ਲੱਗ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਐਵਰੀਥਿੰਗ ਸਟਾਰਟਸ ਵਿਦ ਦੈਟ ਐਂਡ ਇਟ ਵਾਜ਼ ਸੱਚ ਅ ਹਿਲੇਰੀਅਸ ਕਲਿਪ ਕਿ ਦ ਵੇ ਦੈਟ ਸਰਦਾਰ ਗਿਵਸ ਗਾਲੀਸ ਫੋਰ ਐਵਰੀਥਿੰਗ ਗੁੱਡ ਡੀਸੈਂਟ ਇਨਡੀਸੈਂਟ ਬੈਡ ਐਂਡ ਲਵਿੰਗ
Yeah. That's how it
goes. Wo to aega hi aega.
Let's bring Avni back into the conversation. Since it's her film, her work, so she should not be overshadowed today.
No, I'm liking this conversation.
No. When you were filming him, he said, I'm not your father in this. I'm a character in your film. So he demanded a certain element of professionalism in you.
And distance.
And distance.
But I don't think... I have a feeling, I'm not sure because I have seen Raghu direct photographers also, or cameramen when he's being shot. But I don't think he would have said the same thing if you were not related to him. What do you think? I mean, do you think he was being a father and telling you, I'm not your father, I'm a character?
Because I was being a daughter. You know, I would walk in and tell him to repeat things. And he'd say, I'm not an actor. I can't repeat it with so much excitement every time you want me to repeat it because your scene or your where you've shot it is not okay for you. So I was also crossing the line, and then he was also crossing the line by saying whatever he could, because both of us were at some point during the film, he would be able to tell me ki aise shoot karo aur aise shoot karo aur aise nahi karna hai. Because obviously if he's looking at my camera aage se and he shifts the camera like this and checks the lens without looking at the frame, he says ye frame hai to ye bhi aa raha hai wo bhi aa raha hai ye kaato wo kaato, and I'm like nahi. So he would also explain to me like a father, but I would also walk into his space when I wanted to. So he
and
said,
also I didn't want her to get into that ease of being my daughter and taking all the liberties. She should stay alert, awake, and connected with the total experience, every minute of it.
But you were taking liberties as a father by giving her instructions which you wouldn't do to another filmmaker.
He does. You'll be surprised.
I do.
He actually does.
So this is unfair, no?
No, in the sense, basic things. Like these days, you know, youngsters have that extreme zoom, you know, wide angle, 16 to 35 on full frame. And they distort people. You know, even on news channels, the way they distort people, faces, architecture, they have no respect for anything. So that bothers me, you know. Even in 1850s when photography started, and they were doing a lot of photographs of old heritage and architecture. You look at the photographs, the verticals are straight up and clean. And they photographed people, they did portraits with a proper distance, where the perspective of human figure and face was correct and normal. Today they come right up close and distort your face and everything else as if it's a joke. And they think they are being creative.
Now, most of the audience are much younger than Raghu and I. In fact, Raghu and I are so old that we have actually been alive since the first Prime Minister of India.
Yes.
We've actually seen all 16 twice.
But me older.
Yeah, a little bit. But Atal Bihari Vajpayee twice and Indira Gandhi twice. Now, one iconic photograph of Raghu's, of Indira Gandhi, which a poster of hers is in the garbage. And after that, somebody interviewed you about that photograph and asked you, where is your loyalty? Because Raghu had photographed Indira Gandhi extensively, intensively. Yeah. He was known, he was all over the place. So somebody asked him, where's your loyalty? So you answered, loyal to
kutte hote.
And you said, I'm loyal to the situation to capture the truth. Yeah. Right?
No, you see, the fact was that when Indira Gandhi became the Prime Minister, and she was the longest serving Prime Minister of this country, and the fact was initially only Doordarshan, no other channel, all newspapers, every day some function of or the other where Indira Gandhi is coming on political or social or cultural. And you couldn't avoid photographing Indira Gandhi each day and every day. But
Raghu, you also used to say, Indira ji sahi idhar dekhi, Indira ji
sahi. Oh, chodo yaar, dekho, ye iski baatein sabke saamne mat karo.
A life in the day of Indira Gandhi.
No, never. Never. Only once when
iconic
she was
picture
in...
picture of her waving, Indira Gandhi's waving bye to Rahul.
No. I never said that and I never said to anybody. But only thing, you know, when she was in Simla for Simla summit with Bhutto.
Precipice.
And she said that she loves Himalayas. So I said, Indraji, since you are going to be in Himalayas, it would be nice to photograph you. And that's the only time when I made her walk on the parapet, the wall of the place, you know. Because when she was walking on the floor, on the garden, in the garden, you know, the parapet was 3 feet high and I couldn't get her whole figure against the Himalayas. So I stopped taking. She says, any problem? I said, yes, Indraji, I'm not getting my photograph. So she said, what do you want? I said, Indraji, can you climb this wall? She did this and she says, how? I said, I'll get a chair. You see, don't forget the walls in mountains are very thick, you know, 2 feet, 2.5 feet, 3 feet thick. So it was a thick wall, you know.
Raghu, I think she would have walked a tightrope for that picture.
Yes. So she climbed and the best part was, her hand was like this in a mudra. And she knew that she was being photographed. Even in Congress session, she was so alert. She knew who was sitting and photographing from where. So that's the way you do things.
So you've broken rules. When Mother Teresa told you not to film her, you did. And you're surely going to hell for doing that.
Yeah. Because, this is where the magic lies. You know, because when nature sends you some other signals, somebody else has refused you not to do this, who will you follow? The person or the signals from the outer space?
The person.
No, the outer space.
Okay.
He, A very small incident. He visited us on the set when we were shooting Mukkavas.
He started telling you how to.
No, nothing. He was not disturbing us, but we were taking a shot, and suddenly the sound guy says, "Cut, cut, sir, can we take one more?" He says, "There's a constant clicking sound coming." He's sitting there and he's clicking nonstop. He's just shooting nonstop.
He's going to help.
I asked him.
I wanted to please him, you know, so that he doesn't think that I'm not taking photographs.
I see.
Being a cameraman.
He's not
you know?
A politician. You don't have to please him. Avni, you said in the film, I don't know, very beautifully, I don't know if in this journey our cameras will connect us or separate us. Now, if you'd been a parent, you would never ask that question. You can, isn't that true, Raghu?
Yeah, I must say, despite me, the way I have been to her, she's made a, I will not say great film, a wholesome film of a crazy man.
That's
the experience is wholesome. And despite me, she's done it. And now we become very close. I love her.
He's been a very hard father to her, which I can see why. But in his conversations with me, he's also been a very vulnerable, concerned father, wanting to find out about her. So, you know, I've seen both sides of it.
Yeah, nosy parents are good parents. क्या कर रही है किसको देख रही है कहाँ जाएगी गुड योर लास्ट पिक्चर द लास्ट फ्रेम वेयर यू एक्चुअली डिसोबेड हिज ऑर्डर वेयर ही टोल्ड यू फिल द फ्रेम विद लॉट्स ऑफ बर्ड्स एंड यू फिल्ड इट विद हिम डाउन लेफ्ट एंड विद वन बर्ड एंड डायगनल टेंशन विद वन बर्ड टू मी दैट मेंट योर फादर यू हैव लेट योर फादर गो
That's a good interpretation, sure.
That frame also, see, by not having him and saying I would rebel, just fight everything he does or says, that's not right because I do love him and that's why I made the film. So there is a level of respect that is shown in the picture, yet that difference. So that's the frame. So it's, you are there, you are very important, I love you, but I will still do what I want to do.
You, because the bird flew away from the frame. So that was the magical moment for her. She was flying away. That flight for every individual is very precious, regardless of who your mentor, who your father or parents are. It doesn't matter.
It's an amazing ending. And he's got tears in his eyes watching you let go. So he had, it's tough for a parent. But I want to thank all three of you for sharing your genius, your emotion, and Avni on your beginning of a journey, which I think
thank you.
Is going to be. I know that you will get the highest awards in the world. You're on a great path. Well done, bache.
And thank you,
Raghu and Anurag. A very special thank you.
And thank you, Madhu. You are the one. We've had many previous interviews also for News Laundry. She brings out the extract of everybody who comes right into her space. Dangerously nice woman.
I've learned from you, Raghu. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.